Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kopke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. In each one of these episodes, we go over another 3D modeling tool, and today's 3D modeling tool is Melt. And Melt is very similar to Dissolve that we went through previously, so I'm going to also go over what the differences are between the two tools. So let's jump into Cinema 4D and go over how it works. So here we are inside of Cinema 4D, and I have these two spheres here. We have one that has Dissolve, and this is Dissolve's icon, and the hotkey for it is MN, and we have Melt, and this is Melt's icon, and the hotkey for it is UZ. And they're both very similar, and their icons even look very similar. You can see the only difference between the two is this one has two dots, and this one doesn't. And that might actually help you remember this. So what I'll first do is we went over how to select loops. If you're interested in learning about loop selection or how to create loops, you can check out that tutorial. I'll leave it in the description. But for right now, I'll go into edge mode and I'll use the hotkey UL for loop selection. And I'll select this loop and this loop, and we'll use MN to dissolve it. And you'll see that that changed it quite a bit. It removed those two loops. And now we're going to go over to our other sphere and we're going to do the same thing. I'll click here and I'll click here. And this time we're going to use Melt to remove these loops. So we'll use UZ. And this one looks a little bit different, you may notice. And the reason why this one looks different is because this one maintained its points and this one didn't. And that can help you remember why these icons look the way they do and what these tools do. Melt has points. The model has points. It kept the points. Dissolve does not have points in the icon. We do not have points in the model after we've used it. So that makes it really easy to remember. You can see that I can even go in here and select these individual points. And if we go over to our other sphere, there are no points to select. So that is the main difference between these two tools. And they both work in point, edge, and polygon mode. So what I'll do here is I'll just hit undo for a moment so that we get our loops back. Because now we're going to go over how to use this not only in edge mode, because we selected those edge loops, but we're going to show how this could work in point mode. So I'll select a couple points here and I'll use MN to dissolve them. And you can see now they're gone. And it works very similarly with Melt. I'll go over to our Melt sphere. I'll click on these two points here and we'll use UZ. And you can see they look pretty similar and work the same for both. So it removes those points. You can see that now we have two N-gons here. N-gons have more than four edges around the perimeter. And quads have four edges, triangles have three, just as a quick review. So that is how that works in point mode. I'll go back and hit undo once again to get our spheres back to how they were. And this time I'm going to show you how this works in polygon mode. And it's pretty similar. So I'll go back over to our sphere over here. And I'll use UZ, and you can see that it removed that edge in the middle. So these tools are useful for removing edges, points, and in polygon mode, they remove the edges between the polygons that are selected. And now for dissolve, our dissolve sphere, we'll come over here and we'll do the same thing, but using MN. So you can see that these tools are almost identical. The only difference is when you remove geometry, if you keep points or you don't, and it's really easy to remember which one does which because Melt has points literally in the icon and Dissolve does not have points in the icon. So I hope this new tool helps you out and gives you some more understanding because they're so similar. And if you'd like to learn more 3D modeling tools, I go over a new one each week. And if you hit subscribe or like this video, you'll be notified when the next video comes out. And I'll see you next week on Ambient 3D Animations. Thank you so much for watching.